opaque white. How to effectively print white on your labels or packaging. Hello everybody, I'm Stefano. You may have to print on your labels or packaging elements in white color. Today we will see when this printing color is necessary and what are all the techniques you can use to obtain the best possible result in terms of quality. So without further ado, let's jump into action. First of all, you need to know that white is generally used on paper and plastic supports with no starting white background. These materials can therefore be colored papers in the mixture, in the pulp, or transparent plastics, or even metallized materials like silver. We speak precisely of opaque white, as this white has the function of coating the substrate. The opaque white can therefore act as a base for the other colors, replacing the background white for these transparent or colored materials. Being a printed color, it can be made selective, leaving certain areas transparent or metallized as per the substrate. Let's go now to see the various printing techniques that allow you to make the most of opaque white. First of all, we have offset white. Offset white is a white with a very sharp and precise printing. Thanks to the system, the offset system, with which offset plates are engraved. Very fine writings and shades can be obtained thanks to the printing plates. However, offset technology is one of the printing technologies that allow fewer grams of ink to take root on the paper or plastic support. It is not recommended to use it as a white on transparent polypropylene. For example, once the transparent adhesive label is attached to the container, the white will become gray. Just because offset white doesn't have a very high coverage. Porous or dark textured papers are not recommended, as the white, being not very opaque, will be lighter and less visible. This is unless it is required to print a faint white. I personally recommend this printing method on metallized substrates that require white printed images with fine and complex details. Next kind of white, we have Flexo White. Flexographic printing technology allows you to print more grams per cubic centimeter of ink on top of the substrate, which also applies to white. The Flexo White is quite opaque, even if the print itself is not fine and of quality like that of offset. With a single plate, it is not possible to make very precise screens, and therefore the white cannot be faded, cannot be printed like gradients. Printing is recommended when large quantities of labels are required, because of its cost-effective way. Then we have rotogravure white. Rotogravure printing is an excellent gimmick between opacity and print quality. However, large quantities must bear the rotogravure cylinder's costs, which can cost several thousand euros or dollars for every single cylinder. Then we have digital white. Modern printing technologies have allowed both inkjet and laser digital machines to print opaque whites in addition to 4 and 6 colors. Some of these whites can be compared to the coverage of offset and flexo, and the advantages are two. The first advantage is that this printing technology allows, without plate costs, to print even small runs at affordable prices. The second is that with certain printing machines, different strokes of white can be done to enhance it until the required result is achieved. You can print white in different layers to make it more opaque. This type of white can be printed once the paper or plastic has been primed on any kind of surface for labels and packaging. Next, we have silkscreen white. But let's get to the point. Let's talk about screen printing. If you're looking for the best white or opaque white print quality, the advice is to request screen printing. This is because screen printing is the printing technology that allows you to print inks with higher thicknesses than other types of printing methods. More ink equals more opacity and cleaner, more beautiful whites once the label is applied. Screen printing can be done on any material, even porous material, and it can be also used to create white backgrounds and then subsequently be overprinted with offset, for example, offset or flexo inks. Screen printing requires the production of screen printing frames for every single color reference or reference change. In conclusion, if you're looking to get the best opaque white possible within a budget, various aspects need to be considered in your labels or packaging. If you have few labels, few boxes, and a limited budget, digital white printing is highly recommended. If the quantity is higher, you will end up using offset printing, which I recommend only on metallics, or flexo printing for the best result, both in terms of price and quality. We recommend pack white screen printing. If, on the other hand, you have runs of high quantity, like millions of pieces, you may be interested in rotogravure printing. I hope that this video was informative. Don't hesitate to contact me if you want to know which printing techniques are suitable for your project. If you like this video, remember to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any future videos about packaging and design. Share this video with your friends and colleagues. I'm Stefano, and as always, love you all. Ciao!